Back here on Sports Rap Live, ladies and gentlemen, my boy Jay Nature said, just finish strong because it's been a damn good show all night tonight.
Adam, maybe we need to do like in college, you know, when they start running around with the fourth quarter, man.
Fourth quarter. Throw them in the air. Rap Pack, throw your fourth quarters in the air. Here we go. This literally is the fourth quarter. We're going to take it home strong. Andrew, before we get into the bad rap, we do have to hit on a couple baseball stories.
Yeah.
Let's Well, I didn't really – I got the notes written down. I didn't really get a chance to finish the notes because we were over here getting ready for Sports Rap Live. But first and foremost, what do we got about the Astros? We talked a lot about Jim Crane coming in a little too hot, a little too eager.
I said it was a marketing ploy, and I think it was. The fans have spoken. We're keeping the Astros name.
Hallelujah.
We're keeping the Astros logo. I think they might, you know, snazz it up, maybe get some new colorways, maybe get some new flavor going on. But I think what Jim Crane has done is energize the city, get everyone talking about the Astros, which they weren't before. I think there was a lot of negativity about going to the AL, but he's kind of turned that into a positive with this whole little thing about let's see what the fans want. So we're going to keep the team name 50 years, maybe another 50 years of the Astros team, the Astros logo. I think it's going to be really exciting whenever we see the different colorways and the different throwback jerseys on Friday nights. I know you and I will try and be out there as much as we can. I'm going to be covering the team as hard as I can, trying to go to the games and be in the clubhouse, and it's going to be a great Astros season. The team's not going to be the most winningest team out there, but it's going to be the last year in the NL. It's going to be a good way to finish out the season.
Absolutely.
Finish out the NL.
Right. And I think, you know what, this is a great year to do that. You know, kind of clean up the mess that was the last few years of the Astros with Drayton McClain's ownership group. And then, you know, go into this new ownership group 1 year, kind of adjust to him. And then move to the American
League. And Adam, this season we're going to have the number one pick in the draft. And I think there's going to be a lot of buildup for Astros fans talking about who they're going to get. Because I think there are a lot of good players. Maybe not the elite players like a Bryce Harper. But there are going to be a lot of interesting picks. And there's going to be a lot of chatter, Adam. And we're going to break down who Astros fans think that they should take with the number one pick after this season. And Rice just got started with their baseball season. I'm looking forward to that. I'm going to try and make it out to some Rice baseball games. You know, Lance Berkman was a former Rice alum. So I'm going to try and make it out there and see what I can find.
Sure. No, definitely. Now, Lance is still playing in St. Louis.
He is.
And we mentioned Royo. The other day. Yes.
Yeah, supposedly there was a lot of chatter about him, about the Red Sox, and there's a lot of chatter. I think he's between them and the Texas Rangers. And also the Cardinals. I think he might have narrowed it down this week to the Cardinals and the Rangers. So it's going to be interesting to see where he ends up. But, you know, we always support Royo as well. One of our own. Been here for so long, you know. So we'll support him no matter what, but it would not be in the fans' interest to see him play for the Cardinals.
No, but the other option this week, as he meets with Nolan Ryan and some of the management there in Texas, up there in Arlington, is to sign with the Rangers.
Yeah, that would be very interesting. Keep him in Texas. At least we could watch him. But, Adam, how terrible would it be if he spends one season with them and then we see Roy O coming back to face the Astros in the AL West? Oh, that would be a nightmare scenario. I don't want to root against Roy O, but you know what? I'd cheer him like I did Lance when he came back, and then I'd boo the hell out of him.
Sure, ball don't lie.
I root for Houston. I root for the Astros.
Ball don't lie, man. All right, well, Luis.
Yes,
soccer
sir.
Talker, how are you doing?
Doing good. How you doing?
Man, we're great here. You know, look, Rat Pack is
Rat
in full
Pack
effect.
Full.
Did you have a great time out there at the H-Town Sneaker Summit?
Oh, I had a blast. It was great.
You brought your son out there.
I brought my son. And shout out to 39online.com, which I got a tweet from my boy Adam. Had a picture of my son holding his ears. Too much bass.
He was right over there by the wall of bass with DJ Oak Cliff, which was insane. Like, there was points we had to take a break. Yeah. What we were doing because it was so crazy.
That's the back massage center.
Yeah, yep. Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, I know he got to cruise around with his little cousin.
Yep.
And experience the whole thing, man.
Yeah, they were both excited. My little cousin was bragging to my cousin. Oh, it was heaven to him. Seeing all these sneakers, all these hats.
And all the swag he got. I mean, coming by our table, you always end up with stuff.
Yep. He got to meet Vince Young backstage with us, so he's all excited. Just out there bragging, so.
Hell, awesome. I was excited, and I'm 28.
Exactly. Yeah, so. Well, that's awesome, man. Well, hey, I know you got a couple of little tidbits of soccer to tell us about.
Tidbits? Well, the month of February is MLS preseason. Is the hype going to start in a couple of weeks? But the last couple of weeks, it's all about the USA qualifying for the women's, qualifying for the Olympics this year, and then for the men's U.S. soccer fun to get the roll on under Klinsmann.
When does the season officially start, Luis?
It starts the second weekend of March for the MLS.
So as soon as we start getting into the basketball talk, adding more and more for NCAA March Madness, we're going to get into the soccer talk.
Yep.
And we're also going to get and try and get your takes as who do you think is going to win what division. I want all your breakdowns. I want your picks. So be thinking about that. Yep. And also we should get some fans to interaction if they want to talk about who they think are going to win what division and what conference and how they think the who's going to be the champion this next year.
For sure.
Especially a big hype this year, especially for the new Dynamo standing up.
That's going to be a huge event.
Big hype.
I will be there, Luis. I will be there for the opening event. I'll be there, right?
That's what I'm talking about. Yes.
Well, Luis, let me ask you this. Of course, all the listeners out there couldn't see that. But with the Dynamo, they've already started practicing. Is this a team that we can expect things from this year, or is it a team that's going to kind of rebuild as the stadium opens?
I wouldn't consider them being a rebuilding process. Last year, they were the youngest team in the MLS.
Sure.
And they made it to the finals. They got younger by getting rid of Brian Ching, who was the oldest guy in the club. Then Brad Davis is now the oldest guy.
You know who he dates? You know who Brian Ching dates?
No, I don't know, to be honest with you. Do you know?
Yeah. Cougars.
The Cougars, yeah.
Definitely.
We share something in common. I don't like you, Rich, either.
Yeah.
All right. Well, Luis, you're going to bring us all the latest from the pitch. But you know why you're here. Tito, we got that beat on. I can't even hear it, man.
You know what? It's about that time.
The lounge is packed. And you know this show, Cray. And at the end, each and every Thursday night, we bring you our bad rap. And it's such a positive show tonight. Everything's just flowing along.
Well, I want to send one more before we get into this, we got to send a huge, huge shout out to Gons. He held it down on Sunday. He went through more adversity than he probably should have. He held it down. He got us on the airwaves on Sunday. He was reading through owner's manuals. This guy was, you talk about technician, he is the definition of a technician. Not only a DJ, this guy knows his technical stuff. Big shout outs to getting us on the air and getting us right.
Super shout out. That man works
super
right.
Ultra. I mean, he's running right now in first place for the MVP of the sports pack, or the Rat Pack.
Oh, absolutely.
He's running right now number one for the Rat Pack MVP of the year.
Well, not only that, he did it with a smile on his face, you know?
Yep. Hey, always.
A lot of tech guys, I'm sorry, they're just not the most personable people in the world. But Gons, you know what? He can do the tech stuff. He can get on air and chat with us.
He's the sports rap Swiss Army knife.
Very, very much so. But we're also lucky to have somebody like DJ Tito, of course, who gets his own round of applause. Step right in.
I'm honored to be his understudy. That's what I call myself. I'm Gons' understudy.
I don't even know if you're the understudy, man, because a lot of times you're doing things that we can't even see on camera or on air. So shout out to you, Tito. All right, let's get into the bad rap, Luis. I'm going to start with you right down here at the end of the table.
Good. Well, I have two bad raps. Bun B was here earlier.
Yep.
He mentioned his bad rap, which I was kind of surprised.
He passed it on to you to give.
He passed it on to me to give it out online. And his bad rap was on soccer. I was like, whoa, really? Soccer? This was a bad riot that happened in Egypt that the Egyptians said was they blamed the military for the deadly riot.
Wait, they played who?
It was an Egypt team, like the MLS, but in Egypt.
Okay.
74 people were killed during that riot, which were stabbed, choked, or suffocated, or, same thing.
How many people died? I heard a lot of people died.
74 people died.
Damn.
74
terrible.
People. That's why
horrible.
I don't like soccer.
Well, that's a good bad rap. Because
That's a good bad rap, and props to Bun B for mentioning that. My bad rap goes out to the boxing world. Everybody wanted to see the Pacquiao-Mayweather fight. Now, on May 5th, we have to settle for Mayweather versus Miguel Cotto. Whoopee-doo. So,
they ain't getting my money.
Exactly.
My bad rap.
Bad rap to the promoters.
Good one. Andrew, what you got?
My bad rap goes to these people. And shouts out to Phil Mickelson for standing up for himself and his family. He is suing commenters on a blog that were spreading false allegations about his wife and his family. Talking about he had an illegitimate child, Adam, and he had basically some unsavory things to say about him and his family. Shouts up. He might actually have a land mark case as far as suing people who are commenting against him and committing slander against him and his family. You know what, Adam? We take care of each other like family. If someone said that about you, I try and go after them. So shout outs for him to using his power to go after someone online, because if someone's saying that about me, my family, my wife, my children, I would sure as hell try and go after them. So shout out to Phil Mickelson, and bad rap to that guy, whoever is going to get pulled up and sent into court.
Oh, good night. Tito, what's your bad rap, baby?
My bad rap is real quick and easy. It is whoever organized the halftime show for the NFL. Seriously, they get a bad rap. What are you thinking, Madonna? She is 7,800 years old. Nobody wants to watch her. Nobody wants to listen to her. I know. I'm going to change the channel. I know everybody else in the world is going to change the channel.
And you know what's sad? We're going to have that on repeat because we're going to say it again next year.
I know.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, well, real quick, my bad rap goes out to OC Yermanura. And Ben and Bun mentioned it earlier, but OC, what are you doing missing practice or missing a mandatory media session the week of the Super Bowl? I don't understand that. That's not what you want to have going into this game is your name in the media.
That's not preparing like a champion, Adam.
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Well, hey, you know who are the champions of the morning?
790.
The Big Show, of course, and they're out there on Radio Row. Shout out to Wax. Shout out to Matt Jackson. Shout out to Lance Zerline. Make sure you guys keep your knob dialed in for all the Super Bowl coverage. And Charlie Polillo will have his show, and we will be here at Junction Bar and Grill for our own Super Bowl party and Sports Wrap Live Sunday wrap up right here from 8 to 10 p.m.
iHeartRadio app.
That's right. We'll see you guys Sunday. That's a wrap.